Happy day, children. How are you all? I hope you all are fine. Children, welcome back to the class. And today we will study an interesting story about the blind dog. Okay, children, the lesson name is Blind Dog. And this story is written by R.K. Narayan. And R.K. Narayan is a famous writer, okay, in English literature. So he is the person who has written Malgudi Days. Okay, children, and this story is about a man and a dog and how the dog helps the man. So we will see in this lesson, in our lesson, children. Okay, children, this story is a short narrative and it is written by R.K. Narayan, and this story is about a faithful street dog and a blind beggar. This story is about a faithful street dog and a blind beggar, and the writer describes how human beings in the story. The writer R.K. Narayan tells us that how human beings treat the animals, and they're incompassionate, means they humans are not showing love towards the animals. So we will see in this lesson how. Okay, so here the writer describes the incompassionate feeling of a human beings towards the animal. Okay, and in this story the writer tells us that the harrowing, means the cruel and incompassionate attitude of a human being towards animals. Okay, and more than that, every living being on this earth has right to live their life, right? They have right to live their life happily. From small insect to a big, huge animal, so all the human living things on this earth has their right to lead a happy life, right? But what we are doing? So here we are capturing animals, we are keeping animals with us, and we are ill-treating them. We are we are taking their freedom from them. Okay, because for our happiness, we are taking the freedom from the animal. So which is not good, children, because we are taking their rights from them. Right. So this is not good. We should not do like that. And the person here, the author, tells us that the human beings capture animals and for their own selfishness, and how they will ill-treat the animals. Okay, and what is the title of our story? The title of the story is The Blind Dog. Okay, but here the title itself misleads us, because here in this story, it is not the dog who is blind. Instead, it is a person who is blind. Okay, and here, instead of being a blind, he will be having a dog. So this dog will befriend the person, blind person. So how he will help? How the dog will help the blind person to lead his life? All these things we will learn in this lesson, children. And how? So here, blind person. Blind person means he could not see anything, right? And he will take the help of the dog to earn his bread. So dog will take him to the place wherever the blind beggar wants him to go, and he will help the person, blind person, to earn the money. Okay, and this blind person use the dog, okay, to earn his bread. Understood? Now the dog. Now, as we know that dog is a faithful animal, we can't replace any other animal in faithfulness. So dog is faithfulness, and whatever, he'll be ill-treated by the humans. Right, in this story also, the dog shows his faithfulness towards the blind beggar, but blind beggar, what he does, he will ill-treat the dog. He will not take care of the dog properly. He will ill-treat, he will beat. Okay, instead of getting ill-treated by a man, the dog does not leave the blind beggar. Okay, so in his needy time, in his troublesome days also, the dog will be with the blind beggar. Okay, so by this lesson we can understand, this is an example for the faithfulness of the dog, how dog is faithful towards the human beings or towards his man or towards his master. Okay children, now we'll move on to our lesson, main lesson. Here, it was not a very impressive or high class dog, and before that the author is telling that people love animals and keep them as pets. Right, we all love animals and we keep them as pets. Take dogs for example. They are well fed, bathed, groomed and taken out for walks and rides. Their masters get them good medical care. In the end, they are sometimes put to sleep to help them escape the pangs of death. Here, the author is telling that human beings, all people like to keep pets. Example, dog. So we all like to keep dog as our pet animal. So we will give bath to them, we will give good food, and we will give medical care. Everything we'll give, and sometimes we'll put them to sleep. Okay? Instead of, because, so to avoid the sudden death, because all the time they'll be awake. Right? So to help them to reduce the sudden death of dogs, sometimes we put them to sleep. There are also people who keep animals to make them work for them. There are other people who keep animals for their work, to help them in their work. For example, cows, buffaloes, camels. Right? All these animals are kept by the people to help, to take help from them. So to carry luggages from one place to other place. They feed them well to keep them strong. They give nice food to keep the animals strong. So they have to work for them. Now, have you heard of SPCA? That is the Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. Yes, it is. It says we must not treat animals cruelly. Here what the author is telling? He is telling that there is a society. Okay, that society name is Society. There is a society by name Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. Okay, this society tells us that we should not ill-treat the animals. Okay, we should not show cruelty towards animals. So, we have to treat them properly. We have to take care of them with care and love. Now, in this story also, here we can see how the blind beggar ill-treated the dog, though the dog was very faithful towards him. Right, children? So, we'll move on to our lesson. Did you understand, children, this much? This is the story of a blind person and a dog, how the dog helped the blind person in his needy time, though he was ill-treated by the person, blind person. So the blind person was dependent. He was more dependent on the dog to earn his money to live. Okay. Now, it was not a very impressive or high class dog. It was one of those commonplace dogs one sees everywhere. Color of white and dust, tail mutilated at a young age by God knows whom, born in the street and bred on the earnings and garbage of the marketplace. He had spotty eyes and undistinguished carriage and needless pugnacity. Before he was 2 years old, he had earned the scars of 100 fights on his body. When he needed rest on hot afternoon, he lay curled up under the culvert at the eastern gate of the market. In the evening, he set out on his daily rounds. loafed in the surrounding streets and lanes, engaged himself in skirmishes, picked up edibles on the roadside, and was back at the market gate by nightfall. This life went on for 3 years, and then occurred a change in his life. A beggar, blind of both eyes, appeared at the marketplace. An old man led him up there early in the morning. An old woman led him up there early in the morning, seated him at the gate, and came up again at midday with some food, gathered his coins, and took him home at night. The dog was sleeping nearby. He was chilled by the smell of food. He got up, came out of his shelter, and stood before the blind man, wagging his tail and gazing expectantly at the bowl as he was eating his sparse meal. The blind man swept his arms about and asked, "Who is there?" At which the dog went up and licked his hand. The blind man stroked its coat gently from tail to ear and said, "What a beauty you are. Come with me." He threw a handful of food, which the dog ate gratefully. It was perhaps an auspicious moment for starting a friendship. They met every day there, and the dog cut off much of its rambling to sit up beside the blind man and watch him receive alms morning to evening. In course of time, observing him, the dog understood that the passenger by must give a coin by the In course of time, observing him, the dog understood that the passers-by must give a coin, and whoever went away without dropping a coin was chased by the dog. He tugged the edge of their clothes and pulled them back to the old man at the gate, and let go only after something was dropped into his bowl. Among those who frequented this place was a village urchin, who had the mischief of a devil in him. He liked to tease the blind man by calling him names. And by trying to pick up the coins in his bowl, the blind man helplessly shouted and cried and whirled his staff. On Thursdays, this boy appeared at the gate carrying on his head a basket loaded with cucumber or plantain. Every Thursday afternoon, it was a crisis in the blind man's life. A seller of bright colored but doubtful perfumes with his wares mounted on a wheeled platform. A man who spread out cheap storybooks on a gunny sack. Another man who carried colored ribbons on an elaborate frame. These were the people who usually gathered under the same arch. On a Thursday, when the young man appeared at the eastern gate, one of them remarked, "Blind fellow, here comes your scourge." "Oh God, is this Thursday?" he wailed. He swept his arms about and called, "Dog, dog, come here. Where are you?" He made the peculiar noise which brought the dog to his side. He stroked his head and muttered, "Don't let this little rascal." At this very moment, the boy came up with a leer on his face. "Blind man, still pretending you have no eyes? If you are really blind, you should not know this either." He stopped, his hand moving towards the bowl. The dog sprang on him and snapped his jaws on his wrist. The boy extricated his hand and ran for his life. The dog bounded up behind him and chased him out of the market. See the mongrel's affection for this old fellow, marveled the perfume vendor. On one evening, at the usual time, the old woman failed to turn up, and the blind man waited at the gate, worrying as the evening grew into night. As he sat Fretting there, a neighbor came up and said, "Sammy, don't wait for the old woman. She will not come again. She died this afternoon." The blind man lost the only home he had and the only person who cared for him in this world. The ribbon vendor suggested, "Here, take this white tape." He held the length of the white cord which he had been selling. "I give this to you free of cost. Tie it to the dog and let him lead you about if he really so fond of you." Life for the dog took a new turn now. He came to take the place of the old woman. He lost his freedom completely. His world came to be circumscribed by the limits of the white cord which the ribbon vendor had spared. He had to forget wholesale all his whole life and his old haunts. He simply had to stay on forever at the end of that string. When he saw other dogs, friends or foes, instinctively he sprang up, tugging the string, and this invariably earned him a kick from his master. "Rascal, won't you tumble me down? Have sense." In few days, the dog learned to be disciplined in his instinct and impulse. He ceased to take notice of other dogs. Even if they came up and growled at his side, he lost his own orbit of movement and contact with his fellow creatures. Now children, did you understand what happened to the dog? Now here, the author is telling, it was not very impressive or high-class dog. Here the author is describing about the dog. The dog is not from a very impressive breed. So it was normal street dog. It was one of those commonplace dogs one sees everywhere. It is a street dog and a common dog where we can find everywhere on the road. Color of white. What is the dog? How was the dog to look? The color of the dog was white and dirt. Tailed, mutilated at a young age by God knows whom. Here, the tail of the dog had been cut off by someone here. That the author is telling that God knows by whom. Here, even the dog might have not been knowing who has cut his tail. So born in street and bred on the earnings and garbage of the marketplace. And this dog was born on the street and he grew up by eating whatever things he was getting on the garbage in the market. He had spotty eyes and undistinguished carriage and needless pugnacity. Okay, what the author is telling? The author is telling that he had a spotty eyes and he was very impulse, means he was not calm dog. He was very angry dog. For the little reasons he was having a fight. Pugnacity means here fight. So he was fighting among his the street dogs, among the street dogs. So before he was 2 years old. Now before he was 2 years old, in early days when he was small itself, he was not a calm dog or a silent dog. He was fighting among other dogs. So by the time he was 2 years old, he had hundreds of scars, hundreds of marks on his body. That is fighting marks. When he needed rest on hot afternoons, he lay curled up under a culvert at the eastern gate of the market. Here, what the author is telling, when the dog wanted a break, or when the dog needs rest for some time, where he was staying, he was curled up, he was staying or he was resting under the culvert. What do you mean by culvert? So, culvert means a passage, a place or a channel where wastewater was flowing, maybe a sewage water was flowing. So he was taking rest near the culvert, near the passage. Now, at the eastern gate of the market, towards the east gate of the market. In the evenings, he set out on his daily rounds, loafed in the surrounding streets and lanes, engaged himself in skirmishes, picked up edibles on the roadside and was back at the market gate by nightfall. Now, in the afternoon, during afternoon when he wanted rest, so he was sleeping, he was resting under the culvert. So, in the evenings, he was roaming around the marketplace and he was roaming around the street and he was having whatever he finds on the roadside. So, the garbages, the whatever people have thrown, he was eating and he was coming and he was sleeping near the market gate. Now, this life went on for 3 years. Now, here what the author is telling, this life means he was roaming around the street, roaming around the market and he was eating whatever he was getting in the garbage, market garbage. So, like this, he spent 3 years. Now, there is a word, children, skirmishes. What do you mean by skirmishes? Small fight. Skirmishes means small fight. The dog used to have small fights with the other dogs and he used to roam around the market and the street and he was having whatever was left out in the garbage and he was spending his life. And this continued for 3 years. And then occurred a change in his life. After 3 years, a gradual change appeared in his life. And what was that change? A beggar, blind of both eyes, appeared at the marketplace. An old woman led him up there early in the morning. Now what happened? After 3 years, there was a change in the dog's life. So a beggar, a blind beggar. Yeah, the author is telling that the beggar is completely blind. His two eyes were also blind. So he could not see anything. Okay. So a blind beggar appeared in the marketplace. Now an old woman was bringing him early in the morning to the market and later in the evening she was taking the blind beggar to her house. So even she was the only woman who was taking care of the blind beggar and she was also giving food for the blind beggar. Now an old woman left him up there early in the morning, seated him at the gate. She made to sit the blind beggar near the gate and came up again in the midday with some food. And she was coming in the afternoon and she was giving food afternoon meal, gathered his coins and took him home at night. And evening she was collecting all the coins collected by the blind beggar and she was taking the blind beggar to her home. The dog was sleeping nearby. He was stirred by the smell of food. Now here the dog was sleeping near the gate. Right? It was the place where dog was always taking rest. Right. So here as usual the dog was sleeping near the gate. And he was stirred. One day he was stirred. What do you mean by stirred? Stirred means attracted. One day when dog was sleeping near the gate, he will be attracted by the smell of the food. He got up, came out of his shelter and stood before the blind man. What did the dog do? By being attracted by the smell of the food, he will come out of his shelter and he will stand in front of the blind man. Wagging his tail and gazing expectantly at the bowl. Now here what the dog will do? He will start to wag his tail, move his tail and with an expected way, in an expected way, he will look at his bowl. As he was eating his spare meal, the blind man swept his arms about and asked. As he was eating, as he was or he means here blind man. As the blind man was having his lunch, he felt that someone is standing in front of him. So he started to search by spreading his hands. He started to search that who is standing in front of him and asked, who is there? Now, at which the dog went up and licked his hand. By listening to the blind man, the dog went near him and he licked the blind man's arm. The blind man stroked its coat gently from tail to ear and said, what a beauty you are, come with me. Here, by touching the body of the dog, the blind man will be happy and will say, what a beauty. Okay, so he is a blind man, so he doesn't know how the dog looks like. So by touching the body of the dog, he assumes that is a beauty. This dog is very beautiful and he says, you look very beauty and from today you come with me. Well, he threw a handful of food which the dog ate gratefully. Now after greeting the dog, he'll give some handful of food and the dog will become very happy and it will eat the food. It was perhaps an auspicious moment for starting a friendship. Here the author is telling that it was a good day to start a friendship. They met every day there and the dog cut off much of its rambling. Here what the author is telling here, the dog. One day the blind man gave him food. So the next day the dog came and stood in front of the blind man and gradually their friendship developed. Now what happened? Every day the blind man was giving food and they became good friends and they met every day. The dog started to go out. So the dog started to go out in search of food and he was waiting for the blind man to give food. Now, children, here, rambling to sit up beside the blind man. Here the dog cut off much of his rambling. Here, rambling means wandering. Here, the dog stopped wandering for his food. So he was waiting for the beggar to come. Why he was waiting for the beggar to come? So to sit beside him and to watch. Okay, to watch the blind beggar, how people were giving him money. And so a blind man and watch him receive alms morning to evening. Here the dog started to sit with the man and he was watching how the people were giving money. Here alms, what do you mean by alms? Here, arms means here, this L is silent. So we have to pronounce it as arms. Arms means money giving by a person to the poor person. Okay, you might have seen near the temples, the poor people will be sitting. So the other persons will be giving money. So that is called arms. The person who will give money to the poor people is known as arms. So the dog, he started to sit beside the blind person and he was looking at the other person who was giving alms to the beggar, blind beggar. In course of time, observing him, the dog understood that the passerby must give a coin and whoever went away without dropping a coin was chased by the dog. Now, the dog every day he was seeing that the blind person was getting money from the people. So the dog thought that, so whoever goes in front of the blind person, they have to put a coin to the blind person. So those who did not give money, the blind man, so the dog used to chased them and he used to bring them back to the blind person and was making the other person who did not give money to put a coin to the beggar. Now, whoever went away without dropping a coin was chased by the dog. The dog was chasing. He tugged the edge of their clothes and pulled them back to the old man at the gate and let go only after something was dropped in his bowl. Here what the dog was doing? Whoever doesn't give money to the blind beggar, so the dog was pulling their clothes and he was bringing back them to the blind man and he used to make the person by scaring. The dog was making the person to put something into the bowl of the blind beggar. Among those who frequented this place was a village urchin. Here among those means among the people who are frequently visiting the place, among them there was a person or there was a boy who was a urchin. What do you mean by urchin? Archin means a young boy who dressed poorly. So among the frequent visitors, the one boy was Archin, a young boy who used to tease the blind man, who used to trouble the blind man by calling the names. Now, and by trying to pick up the coins in his bowl, what this Archin was doing? What this boy was doing? He was teasing the blind man. He was saying, was taking the coins collected by the blind man. The blind man helplessly shouted and cried and wriggled his staff. Now here what the blind man was doing? He was helpless because he couldn't see. So with helpless, he was shouting and he was crying and he was wriggled. Wriggled means? Now, wriggle means turn around. Staff. Here, staff means the blind person. You might have seen the blind person will be holding a stick. Right? So, that is called staff. So, when the urchin was troubling the blind man, so he was helplessly crying and shouting and he was turning away his staff. Okay? To look who is in front of him. On Thursday, this boy appeared at the gate carrying on his head a basket loaded with cucumber or plantain. Here the boy used to visit the markets on Thursdays. So this Thursday was a bad day for the blind beggar because this urchin, this boy was troubling the blind man. So Thursday was a bad day. And every Thursday afternoon it was a crisis in the blind man's life. Here what the author is telling, every Thursday the afternoon was a terrible day for the blind man because this urchin, this young boy who was very naughty, who was very cruel towards the blind beggar. He was teasing him, he was collecting all the coins which was collected by the blind man and he was troubling him. So Thursday was a very bad day. Now a seller of bright colored but doubtful perfumes with his wares mounted on a wheeled platform, a man who spread out cheap storybooks on a gunny sack, another man who carried colored ribbons on an elaborate frame. These were the people who usually gathered under the same arch. Here what the writer is telling? Along with the blind man, along with the blind person or blind beggar, there are other persons though who are selling their things. Who are the other persons? There was a ribbon vendor and a person who was selling storybooks and a perfume vendor. Okay, so these three were the other persons who were selling their things in the market under the same arch, in the same place. where beggar or the, where the blind beggar was collecting the alms. Now, on a Thursday, when the young man appeared at the eastern gate, one of them remarked, "Blind fellow, here comes your scourge." Here what the author is telling? Here, one day on Thursday, the other person, the perfume vendor will say, "Blind fellow, see here, there is a boy is coming, a boy who troubles you is coming towards you." Now the blind beggar will become scared, he'll be frightened. Right. So what do you mean by scourge? Who is called scourge? Someone who troubles you. The person who troubles us is called scourge. Here, the perfume vendor will tell the blind man that, "Blind fellow, see, the scourge is coming towards you." Scourge means a person who troubles you is coming towards you. "Oh God, is this Thursday?" he wailed. And here, he will make a sad voice. So, "Oh God, is this Thursday?" So he swept his arms about and called. Now he swept his arms and he called, "Dog, dog, here, where are you?" Now he called the dog to come near him. He made a peculiar noise which brought the dog to his side. Here he made a peculiar, a different noise so that the dog came towards him. The dog understood that the blind person is in danger, is in trouble. Now he stroked his head and muttered. Now when the dog came near him, he muttered few words. "Don't let that little rascal." At this very moment, the boy came up with a leer on his face. Now he called the dog, the blind man, he called the dog and he said, "So don't leave that little rascal." Rascal means here a naughty fellow. Okay, so don't leave that naughty boy towards me. Okay, now by the time the blind man was talking to the dog, the naughty fellow will come towards the blind fellow with a sad or unpleasant feeling. Okay, so blind man, still pretending you have no eyes. Now when the boy came with a pleasant look towards the blind man, he will ask question for the blind man. "Blind man, are you still pretending?" Here the boy is thinking that this blind beggar is doing acting. So he is not a really blind. So he is telling, "Are you still pretending to be a blind? If you are really blind, you should not know this either." Here what the naughty fellow is telling? He's telling that if you are a blind, then you should not know that who is coming near to you, right? So I think you can see. Now he stopped his hand moving towards the bowl, and now the little boy stopped moving towards the bowl of the blind beggar. The dog sprang on him and snapped his jaws on his wrist. Now here what the dog did, as the little boy was talking to the blind man, here the dog jumped on him and he started to bite his wrist. The boy extricated his hand and ran for his life. Here the boy removed his hand and he ran for his life. The dog bounded up behind him and chased him out of the market. Here what the dog did? The dog did not leave him. So the dog ran after him and the dog made the naughty boy to run away from the market. "See, the mongrel's affection for this old fellow," marveled the perfume vendor. What the act was going on was seen by the three other persons. So among them, the perfume vendor will say to the other person that, see how love the dog is showing towards the blind beggar. One evening at the usual time, the old woman failed to turn up and the blind man waited at the gate. Now, on one evening, what happened here? As we learned earlier that an old woman was taking care of this blind person, right? So one evening, the old woman will not come to the market to give food for the blind beggar. So he'll be worried because he was hungry and he'll be worried why this old lady did not come. So, and worrying as the evening grew into night, he was worried because he could not go, he doesn't know the way to go to the house. Every day the woman was coming and she was taking him to the house. So now the evening passed and it became night. So now the man became very worried. Now what happened? As he sat fretting there, a neighbor came up and said, as he sat fretting, here fretting means worrying. As he was sitting in a worried manner, a neighbor person will come to the blind man and he will say, Sammy, don't wait for the old woman. She will not come again. She died this afternoon. What did the neighbor inform? The neighbor tells us that, Sammy, don't look for the old woman. Now she will not come again to pick you. So she had died in the afternoon. Now what happened? What is the situation of the blind beggar? Now the blind man lost the only home he had, the only person who cared him in this world. Okay, the ribbon vendor suggested, here, take this white tape. Here what happened to the blind man? Now the blind man become worried because he had only one home. Okay, the old woman was taking this blind man with her to her home. Now she has died. Now who will take care of him? Now she was the only person in this whole world who was taking care of the blind man. Now blind man doesn't have anyone to take care of him and he also doesn't have a house to live. So now the blind man will become worried. By the time the ribbon vendor will come towards him. Now the ribbon vendor will come and he will say, here take this white tape. So what I am telling, so take this white tape. I held a length of white cord which he had been selling. I will give this to you free of cost. Tie it to the dog and let him lead you about if he really is fond of you. Now hear what the tape vendor or the ribbon vendor will say. He will come near to the beggar and he will say, take this white tape. So if the dog is fond of you, if the dog really loves you, so tie this thread or tie this ribbon to the dog's neck and take his help, and wherever you want, you can go with the help of the dog. Now life for the dog took a new turn now. Now by all these days, the dog was happy. So he was free. He was not in control of anyone. So whenever he wants, help the beggar, he was coming. Now the life gradually changed. The life changed, or the life took a new turn in the dog's life. He came to take place of the old woman. Now who came to help the blind man? The dog. The dog took the place of a old woman. He lost his freedom completely. Now the dog lost his freedom completely. His world became circumscribed by the limits of the white cord which the ribbon vendor had spared. Here, now the dog world became restricted. Here, circumscribed means restricted by the limits. Now the dog was not free. So he was in control of the other person because the ribbon vendor had given a tape to tie around the dog's neck and the blind person will be having the control of the dog. So he has lost all his freedom. He was restricted to the limit. He had to forget wholesale all his old life and all his old haunts. Here what happened? Here Now the dog has to forget old self. Old self means together. So the dog has to forget all his old life, means being free. So now the dog can't go wherever it wants. And he also tells us that he also lost the freedom of going to the old haunts, means the same places, old places where the dog enjoyed. So he simply had to stay on forever at the end of that string. Now here the dog has to stay in the control of the string by the blind man. When he saw other dogs, friends or foes, instinctively he sprang up, tugging the string, and this invariably earned him a kick from his master. Now what happened? Now the thread or the ribbon was in control of the blind man. So when the dog saw his other fellow dogs were enjoying, were jumping around, so even this dog also would love. So even he was going in that way. So when he was going in the way where his friends, the other dogs were enjoying, the blind man was having his control over the dog and he was kicking him. He was ill-treating him. Rascal, won't you tumble me down? Here what the blind man was addressing him as, rascal, do you want me to fall down? Have some sense. So in few days the dog learned to discipline his instinct and impulse. Now in few days, by the behavior of the blind man, now the dog started to learn the discipline. He left all his the earlier life, means enjoying the life. So now he started to behave in a disciplined manner. He ceased to take notice of other dogs. Now he did not care to take the notice of other dogs. Even if they came up and growled at his side, he lost his own orbit of movement and contact with his fellow creature. Here what we understood, that when the other dogs were coming and growling at him, means making angry sound, he was not caring because he was not having control over himself, because he was under the control of the blind man. If he used to go here and there, so he was getting beatings. He was ill-treated by the blind man. So he left, means concentrating on the other dogs. Right, children? Did you understand this much, children? Okay, now, children, this is a story. Okay, this is a story about the blind dog. Actually, in this story, the dog is not blind. Instead, the person was blind. Here, the dog will help the blind person when he needed help. Understood? Now, what happened? This dog was normal street dog. So he was roaming all around the marketplace, all around the street, and he was feeding, having food himself, and he grew up into a big dog. So this happened 3 years. Okay. And later, after 3 years, his life, the dog's life, started to change. A person enters his life. Who is that person? That person was a beggar and he was a blind. So an old woman was taking care of the blind man. So this, what the blind man was doing, the blind man was brought by the old woman to the market, and she was making the blind man to sit in the gate, and he was asking money. He was asking alms with the people. So other people were giving the money. So like this way he was earning. And what the old woman was doing? The old man was bringing food in the afternoon, and he was collecting the coins which was collected by the blind person, and she was taking him in the evenings to her house. This happened for some days. So gradually this dog was sleeping in the gate, and it started to observe the blind man, and it also was attracted by the smell of the food which the beggar was having. So one day it will come near to the beggar when he was having his lunch. Now the blind beggar understood that someone, or he felt that someone is standing in front of him. So he will ask, who is in front of me? Who is there? So the dog, by listening to the blind man, he will go near him and he will lick his hand. Now, what the blind man will do? the blind man by touching his body, by touching the dog's body, he will say, how beautiful you are. From today onwards, you come with me. And he will give a handful of food. So the dog will become very happy and it will have the food given by the beggar. So by these things, it continues for days and the blind man and dog will become friends. And one day what happened? The old woman will not come to pick the blind man. So the blind man will become worried because in the afternoon he did not have his lunch and evening have passed and now it became night. So the blind man doesn't know how to go to his house. Right. So he was worried and he was waiting in the same place. So now the neighbor will come. One of the neighbor will come and he say, Sammy, you don't wait for the old woman because she'll never come back again because she had died in the afternoon. So by listening to the death of the old woman, the beggar, blind beggar will become worried. Why? Because he was having the only one house which the old lady was taking him. Okay. So and he was having the only one person in the whole world who was taking care of him. That is the old lady. Now, when the old lady is died, now he, the blind man also doesn't have home and he also doesn't have anyone to take care of him. So now the blind beggar became very worried. Now what happened? By seeing this, now there were other persons who were doing their business in the place where the blind beggar was asking alms. Okay, who are the three people? The three people were the ribbon vendor, the perfume vendor, and the person who was selling the storybooks. Now by seeing the blind beggar worried, now what the ribbon vendor will say? The ribbon vendor, he'll come to the blind beggar and he'll give a string of white ribbon to him. And he will say, beggar, take this white ribbon and tie it to the neck of the dog. So if the dog is very fond of you, he will help you. Take his help and you can earn your money. Now here this side, what the dog was doing? The dog used to observe that all the people were giving money to the beggar. So the dog understood that, or the dog thought that whomever goes in front of the blind beggar, they have to give something to the beggar. Now the person who did not give or did not lend something to the blind beggar, the dog used to run back of them and he used to tug their shirt or the tug their clothes, and he was bringing that person back to the blind beggar, and the dog was making the person by scaring so to give something to the blind beggar. So by seeing this, the ribbon vendor was surprised. So he thought that the dog is showing his love towards the blind beggar. And when the blind beggar was worried, he'll give ribbon and he will tell to tie the white ribbon around the dog's neck and take the help of the dog. So wherever the blind beggar wants to go, he can ask the, he can take the help of the dog and he can move. Now this changed the life of the dog. Right. Now the dog was free all these days. He was not in control of anyone. But now as he was tied with the ribbon and he was in control of the blind beggar, now he has to lose all his freedom. He can't go wherever he wants. He can't eat whatever he wants. Now this dog has taken the place of the old woman. Right. Now gradually the blind beggar started to behave in a different way. Now the blind beggar completely dependent on the dog. So when the dog used to see his fellow dogs were jumping and enjoying in the street, so the dog used to or try to go to that way to enjoy. So what the blind beggar was doing? He was controlling him. He was pulling the dog and he was ill-treating him. He was kicking. So he was telling that, rascal, are you? Do you want me to fall down? So have some common sense. So don't go anywhere. I am taking the control of you. So you should not go anywhere and you should be with me. So this changed the life of the dog. Now he can't go anywhere. He can't enjoy. He can't eat whatever he wants. And he can't take rest also. Because as long as the blind beggar wants to walk or wants to earn money, the dog has to take him to the places where the blind beggar was telling him. So now the dog lost all his old life. Right? And he also started to ignore. So when the other dogs were coming and growling at him, he was not caring him because he was in control of the other person. Right? If he wanted to go out of that control, he was getting beatings. He was getting ill-treated. So the dog stopped to respond to the other dogs. Children, I hope you have understood. And there are few words and their meanings, children. And first one is culvert. What do you mean by culvert? A passage where waste was flowing. Culvert, passage where waste was flowing. Now, skirmisher, small fight. Skirmisher, small fight. Stirred, attracted. Stirred, attracted. Now, rambling, wandering. Rambling, wandering, alms, money given by a person to the poor person. Alms, money giving by a person to the poor person. Urchin, a young boy who dressed poorly. Urchin, a young boy who dressed poorly. Vrilled, turn around. Vrilled, turn around. Now, scourge, someone who troubles you. Scourge, someone who troubles you. Children, I hope you have understood the story this much. And the next part of the story, we will learn in the next class, children. Thank you, children.